Hello, in this tutorial we will discuss non-emulsifying agent. So we'll start our introduction with the definition that what is emulsion. So emulsion is formed when two or more immiscible liquids are mixed with each other. As we can see in this diagram, there are two liquids. The first liquid is water and the second liquid is oil. So when these two immiscible liquids come in contact with each other, emulsion is formed. Talking about the types of emulsions, there are two types of emulsion. The first one is oil in water emulsion and the second is water in oil emulsion. When we say oil in water, it means oil is present in water, means water is acting as a continuous phase. As we can see here, water is the continuous phase and oil is present as a dispersed phase. That is, oil is in lesser quantity as compared to the quantity of water. In case of oil in water emulsion, the viscosity is lesser as compared to water in oil emulsion. When we say water in oil emulsion, it means water is present in the oil. Water is acting as a dispersed phase and oil is present as a continuous phase. When we talk about the petroleum reservoir, water in oil emulsion is actually the problem. Okay, here we will see emulsion formation and prevention mechanism. When a treating fluid comes in contact with crude oil, varying degree of emulsion can take place. Most emulsions are water in oil emulsions, that is, oil is present as external phase or oil is present as a continuous phase. Most crude contains emulsifying agents that have the capability to generate a stable emulsion downhole, resulting in the formation damage or plugging the formation. The emulsions can be stabilized by formation fines and asphaltenes. Now we'll see that what is meant by non-emulsifier. So the chemicals which are added in the treatment fluid to prevent the formation of emulsion are known as non-emulsifiers. When we add these chemicals into the treatment fluid, they have the ability to break emulsions. However, it takes relatively higher concentration to break the emulsion than does it take to prevent the emulsion. So what should be our strategy? Our strategy should be that we should add the non-emulsifying agent in the treatment fluid so that we could avoid the problem of formation of emulsion than to cure the formed emulsion. Since most emulsions are all external, they can be diluted in diesel. Conversely, a water external emulsion can be diluted in water. Also, heat will aid in breaking most emulsions. The type and concentration of non-emulsifier should be determined in the lab. Overdosage can be problematic and even can stabilize the emulsion. That's it. Thank you very much for watching. See you in the next tutorial.